नाउ रोल्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन मेकिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स, दैट इज कॉस्मेटिक्स एंड केमिस्ट्री. सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू नो व्हाट आर दिस कॉस्मेटिक्स. वेरियस नेचुरल इंग्रेडिएंट्स सच एज मिल्क, रोज पेटल्स एंड मेहंदी हैव बीन इन यूज एट एज होम रेमेडीज फॉर स्किन प्रॉब्लम्स एंड अदर पर्पसेस. सच आइटम्स दैट आर यूज टू मेक एक्सटर्नल बॉडी पार्ट्स क्लीन. सच आइटम्स द आइटम्स दैट आर यूज टू कीप एक्सटर्नल बॉडी पार्ट्स क्लीन, हेल्थी एंड गुड लुकिंग आर कॉल्ड कॉस्मेटिक्स. सो वॉट आर कॉस्मेटिक्स? द आइटम्स दैट आर यूज टू कीप एक्सटर्नल बॉडी पार्ट क्लीन, हेल्थी एंड गुड लुकिंग आर कॉल्ड कॉस्मेटिक्स. देर आर मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स वी यूज सच एज टूथपेस्ट, टलकम पाउडर, सोप, सुअर जेल्स, शैम्पूस, ऑयल्स, कंडीशनर, नेल पेंट्स, लिप पेंट्स, ऑल आर दिस आर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स एंड ऑल आर दिस आर गिफ्ट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. ऑल ऑफ दिस कॉन्टेन सिंथेटिक केमिकल्स. सिंथेटिक केमिकल्स आर जेनरली नॉट गुड फॉर आस एज दे आर मोर टॉक्सिक देन नेचुरल सब्सटेंसेस एंड मे कॉज हार्म टू आवर बॉडी. इन कॉस्मेटिक प्रोडक्ट्स वाटर वाटर इमल्सिफायर, प्रिजर्वेटिव्स, थिकनर्स, पीएच स्टेबिलाईजर्स, डाइज, ऑल दिस डिफरेंट सब्सटेंसेस कॉम्बाइन इन डिफरेंट रेशियो. सो दिस आर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सम कॉस्मेटिक्स. ओके, मोस्ट ऑफ द फॉर्मिंग कॉस्मेटिक्स प्रोडक्ट सच एज टूथपेस्ट, शैम्पू एंड सोआर जेल हैव सोडियम लॉरियल सल्फेट और सोडियम लॉरियत सल्फेट एज एन इंग्रेडिएंट. टलकम पाउडर हैज मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट एंड जिंक ऑक्साइड. क्रीम कॉन्टेन्स जिंक ऑक्साइड. नेल पेंट्स एंड लिप कलर कॉन्टेन्स टाइटेनियम डाइऑक्साइड. सो दिस आर कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स. दैट इज क्वेश्चन विल आस्क दैट स्टेट द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ टालकम पाउडर. यू हैव टू राइट मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट एंड जिंक ऑक्साइड. एंड व्हाट आर द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ क्रीम और कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ क्रीम? यू हैव टू आंसर दैट आंसर इज जिंक ऑक्साइड. टाइटेनियम ऑक्साइड इज ऑल्सो यूज इन सनस्क्रीन दैट गिव्स अस कंप्लीट प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम द सन रेज विदाउट फॉर्मिंग व्हाइट लेयर ऑन द स्किन. सो दिस आर इफेक्ट्स और इम्पोर्टेंट रोल्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन मेकिंग डिफरेंट कॉस्मेटिक्स. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स एंड देयर कॉम्पोनेंट्स. Which component, which chemicals are present in that component, cosmetics, you have to remember. Now, clothing and industry. The exact time when clothing came in use is not known, but it is believed to have started about 30,000 years ago. The basic clothing used by our ancestors could possibly be leaves to hide and protect their bodies. Gradually, animal skin and vegetation were adopted as protection from the weather conditions. Around 3000 BC, production of silk through silkworms started in China. The use of cotton in the form of unstitched unstitched fabric started in India around the same time. So, cotton, linen, flax, hemp fiber, and wool are the most commonly used natural fiber. So, some common example of natural fibers are cotton, flax, hemp fibers, and wool. Natural fibers are obtained from plants and or animals. Recently, man started making fibers from chemical substances. Such fibers are called synthetic fibers. So, what are synthetic fibers? The man started making fibers from chemical substances, and these fibers are called synthetic fiber and are more durable. These fibers are more durable than natural fiber and easy dyeability in any color, stretching, waterproofing, and color fastness and long lasting properties of synthetic fibers made them more popular. Some common example of synthetic fibers such as terylene, made up of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. Terylene, made up of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acids, or nylon, made up from adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine. Nylon is a synthetic fiber which is made up from adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine. Artificial silk or rayon, polyester are the most popular fabrics. And these synthetic fibers have disadvantages or have some disadvantages too. They can cause allergy and stickiness. They are not meant for all weather and can cause fire immediately. This lead to the growth of semi-synthetic blended fibers such as terricot. Terricot is a semi-synthetic blended fibers, which is a combination of terylene and cotton. So what is terricot? Terricot is a semi-synthetic fiber, which is a combination of terylene and cotton. The textile industry is growing every day with innovation which are driven by market demand and creativity of fashion houses. So these are some roles of chemistry in making clothes. The materials of clothes, different types of fibers, natural fiber, you have to remember examples of natural fiber, synthetic fiber, semi-synthetic fiber, and their composition. Now, chemicals in medicines. All types of medicines are chemicals. So, medicines are chemical substances also called drug. And medicines used for treatment, cure, and prevention of disease. Medicines which are used for the treatment, cure, and prevention of disease. They are obtained from plants and animals or prepared from chemicals. Medicines can also be classified into many categories depending on the purpose they are used for. A few of these classes are discussed here. First type of medicine is antibiotics. Antibiotics are chemical compounds that prevent infection caused by microorganisms and worked by either in inhibition their growth or by killing them. So example of antibiotics, black pepper is a good natural antibiotic. Black pepper. So antibiotics are chemicals compounds that prevent infection caused by microorganisms. Some other common man-made antibiotics are penicillin, streptomycin, amoxicillin. These are man-made antibiotics. Antibiotics are usually taken in the form of pills or injections. Some are externally applied as creams. Antibiotics are originally obtained from microorganisms such as bacteria, fungi. Now a number of them are manufactured using chemicals. Next type of medicine is analgesics. Analgesics are medicines that are used for relieving pains. Analgesics are medicines that are used for relieving pains. Aspirins and paracetamols are common examples of analgesics. So analgesics are medicines that used for relieving pain. Examples, aspirin and paracetamol. Antipyretics are medicines that reduce fever. So antipyretics, what are antipyretics? Antibiotics are medicines that reduce fever. Example of antibiotics, aspirin, paracetamols are examples of antipyretics. Next, antiseptics. Antiseptics are medicines that prevent the growth of microorganisms. Example of antipyretics, turmeric and marigold are good natural antiseptics. Antiseptics are medicines that prevents the growth of microorganisms. An example of antiseptics are turmeric and marigold are good natural antiseptics. Now, antihistamine. Antihistamine. These are medicines that prevent or cure allergic reactions such as rashes and breathlessness. So, antihistamines are the medicine prevent or cure allergic reactions such as rashes or breathlessness. Next, antacid. Antacids are medicines that give relief from the excess of acid production in the stomach. Antacids are medicines that give relief from the excess of acid produced in the stomach. Example of antacids, milk of magnesia. That is suspension of magnesium hydroxide in water is used to relieve the burning sensation or stomach pain due to acidity. Mint leaves act as an antacid and are good for treating indigestion. Okay, so these are different types of medicines, and you have to remember the definitions and example of this type of medicines. And question will ask like that, define antipyretics, give one example of antipyretics. Okay.